Hello and welcome to 10 Minute Takes. This is not a review, but a mid-90s discussion. The way we like to do things here at 10 Minute Takes is that we like to give our recommendation first. I don't know what Sam's going to say. She doesn't know what I'm going to say. And then our discussion stems from our recommendations. So Sam, with that said, are you ready to give it?
Yes.
Our recommendations. Are you ready to give our recommendations?
You said it so weird. Okay, yes.
It's okay. 3, 2, 1.
See it.
So what did you guys think? Is the see it, wait for it, or pass it? If you've seen it, if not, are you excited to see it? Follow along in the discussion below in the comments. We will respond. So with that said, let's jump into the discussion. So mid-90s is, man, I don't know if it's so much of a story, but it's a slice of life film about a kid that it's pretty much like takes place over the course of a summer. And it's about a kid that befriends a group of skater kids at a local skate shop. And that's essentially our film. It's them during the summer just being friends and hanging out. Mm-hmm. And the thing that I absolutely loved about this, and it's probably for me, I mean, it's probably be different for me than from a lot of other people, because it was a massive nostalgia trip for me as someone who grew up in the 90s. Like, I knew people like those kids. I hung out at skate shops like that. I listened to that same music. I had the same clothes. Like, I was the details, even down to, like, the belt that those kids wear. I was like, I had that belt. My brother had that belt. My neighbors had that belt. Kids in my school had that belt. But anyway, Sam, did it resonate as much with you as it did with me?
Yes, it did, actually. I think that this film really resonates with the boys that grew up in the 90s.
Yeah.
It was very, I never skateboarded. I didn't know a lot of girls that skateboarded. I'm sure they were there. There were a few scenes with girls in it, and the tube top, the striped tube tops with the scrunching in their hair. I remember that outfit, even though this is kind of a boys movie.
That's very much a boys movie.
And about boys that grew up in the mid-90s, it would be really interesting to see the girls' perspective of the mid-90s.
That'd be a cool movie. I'd be down for a mid-90s girls film. And this film encapsulates that culture. Mm-hmm. And I feel like if you're someone that's not going to understand that culture, that you didn't grow up with it and you're not going to resonate with it, this might not be a movie for you.
Yeah, I think you were very surprised that I enjoyed it as much as I did, only because I grew up in the 90s, but not the way that you did. Mm. I was a little bit younger during this film particularly, but it still brought me back to the feeling of what the 90s was, the technology in the 90s. I just made that connection in that sense.
Yeah, I had the Super Nintendo, the PlayStation, even the kid with his, I have an older brother. Now, me and my other brother didn't have the relationship that these kids had.
The relationship between the brother and, between the brothers was,
it was intense.
Right, it was a brother relationship times 10.
Yeah.
And I think that's really what drove the little kid to these group of friends and to the decisions that he made in the film was really because of the stem of it came from the brother. But you also learn why the brother was the way that he was. Mm-hmm. And I really liked that. You were like, okay, I get it. Doesn't make it right, but I get it.
Yeah. No, I was able, not that it resonated with him, but like you, I was able to understand where the brother's aggression was coming from.
Yes.
They showed us what was going on with the brother. There's one particular scene. It was a little weird to me because, for one, the movie itself is encapsulated with the 90s soundscape, is what I would call it. From the music. From like the music, the sound effects, everything like the TV's playing in the background. There's always other elements to what's going on in the scene besides the dialogue.
Right.
There's always some other sound there. And this one particular scene that you're talking about, they're playing a video game and the older brother and the younger brother are sitting there on a couch, but you don't, it's the one scene in the film where you do not hear something else besides people talking.
Right.
It's the only scene that doesn't have background noise.
I didn't catch that.
It bothered me a little bit when that happened because when I was watching it, I was like, there's no way that I would ever be sitting on a couch with my older brother or my friends playing a video game and we'd have the TV on mute. Would not be happening. It bothered me a little bit.
Well, I mean, no. But rebuttal.
What's your rebuttal?
My rebuttal is that you needed to have all of that on mute to really understand what this poor kid was going through, and he was trying to fill his brother in, and he was in this moment, this was the one moment where his older brother was really trying to protect his younger brother, and you really got the feeling that he couldn't control the way that he treated his brother, and he was trying to express it. And I thought that it was okay that all of that background noise was off, because you really got to tune in and be like, oh, you know what? Good for you for being able to express this to your brother and protect your brother. Even though you know that you're not going to change, you were able to voice that. And that's important.
I agree with you. And I think that's the point of why there was no background scene, because that's the one scene where the two brothers actually kind of connect with one another, where they kind of see eye to eye on the same page. And I appreciated the art of it. It just, I would have liked to have been able to remain encapsulated with the 90s sound, with the way that they were portraying the 90s in that moment. But I get the artistry behind it.
But also the PlayStation didn't come out until like the late 90s, didn't it?
That was like 98. I don't know the exact date. But anyways, beyond...
Fact to look up, comment below. Let us
know. When did the PlayStation come out?
When did the first PlayStation come up? I'm very curious.
Another thing is that the acting of this film is fantastic. I don't know who any of these people are. I've never seen them outside of Lucas Hedges, of the two brothers and the mom, the family. So you know a lot. But like the four skater kids who make up a majority of the film, I have no idea who they are. I've never seen these people before.
I agree. The oldest brother, he's coming up in another film, and he's been in a few
Boy
films.
Erased.
I want to see that.
Yeah.
Anyway. He's been in a lot of films, and he is really making his mark.
Yeah, he's good. Great. He was in Lady Bird as well, with that Timothée Chalamet was also in, which we did, A Beautiful Boy. And he's just coming up. He's fantastic actor. This is a different turn. He was in Manchester by the Sea, which I liked a lot from last year. I thought Manchester by the Sea was amazing. I love that movie. This is a sort of like a good turn for him to play a dramatic role. He's not just like he's playing more than just like a son or a teenager to somebody. He's like an aggressive older brother.
He was pretty dramatic in Lady Bird. He had a pretty dramatic role.
Not like this. Not where he was like trying to play the tough guy.
No, but it was a different type of dramaticism. It was a different type of drama.
Yeah, but I just thought he was able to portray this. Not a lot of people can make the transition from just your drama about sort of inner conflict and drama with being sort of like the tough guy. I was very impressed with the mom. She's from Fantastic Beasts.
That's what it is. I couldn't figure out where she was from.
And she didn't blow me away in Fantastic Beasts. I actually wasn't blown away by Fantastic Beasts. I'm not a big Harry Potter fan.
I am.
Yeah, I know you are. But she won me over in this film. I thought she was fantastic. I don't remember her from anything else. If she's been in other stuff, maybe I haven't caught it. But she was absolutely amazing in this. She was fantastic. Loved her. The four skater kids, I have no idea who they are. I'd like to look them up and see if they've been in anything else. Because they were all really good.
That curly hair kid. What was his name?
We won't say it here because it's FS.
Oh yeah.
We won't say it here. Family show. We'll keep it PG. But his name, his nickname's a curse word. It's two curse words.
Well, he has a normal name too. We didn't have to call
him that.
He was good.
I don't know if he was just playing himself or if he's playing a character. He was great. The guy that played, I think his name was Ray. I believe they called him Ray Ray.
He wanted to be a skater.
Yeah, he wanted to be a pro. Was there anything about this film that you didn't like?
I was a little turned off by the ending. Just
not like the ending or like the last act?
The ending. Like there was right before the credits roll.
Okay.
Because I wanted more after it.
I felt like that was a common theme in the film because when the film actually hit the credits, I heard a lot of like, what?
I was like, wait, what? And then when you said something right after and I was like, okay, I get it. But if you weren't there and I was seeing this on my own, I'd be like,
It's a little perplexing.
But then again, the fact that it's like an hour, it's an hour and 20 minutes, it gets to the point.
It's a quick watch.
It's straight to the point, and it only needed to be an hour and 20 minutes.
Yeah.
It didn't need to be longer than that. It was great.
I'm with, I'm not 100% on board with not liking the ending. I actually kind of like the way they ended it, because I thought it brought home the fact that it's the mid-90s. It was just a slice of life film, and I feel like that last minute just brought that home.
Right.
The last, I want to say 20 minutes of the film got a little long in the tooth for me. It felt like they almost tried to get too dramatic. And my favorite parts of the film is when they were just hanging out being friends. And when the film took a turn for the more dramatic and they tried to bring a little bit more of an arc to it.
Sure.
Turned me off a little bit. I wasn't 100% on board because I felt like the drama with the friends was kind of forced a little bit.
Okay.
And there's one scene I felt like turned the whole audience off. There's one party scene that I felt like was uncalled for.
Oh, that was weird.
Yeah. So if you've seen it, you know what we're talking about. Let us know what you thought in the comments, because we also thought that was weird. A lot of people in the audience thought that was weird. We were in like the second row. I wouldn't be surprised if some people walked out of the theater at that point. But it got pretty uncomfortable. But that scene kind of turned me off. Luckily, it didn't go too far. It went pretty far, but not too far in my book. What was your favorite scene in this movie?
My favorite scene was the kid's realization of that his life could be much worse. What?
You took mine. That's mine too.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's my favorite scene.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. We can share in the same scene. We both. That was my favorite scene too.
You were like, love, nope.
Down.
Off. Over it. Love, done.
No, that to me, I feel like a lot of people walking out of the theater will probably think that that's, we'll probably come away with that being their favorite scene. It's a scene where the kid's really down on his luck, racist down with him, and goes, hey, you wouldn't trade the skeletons you have in your closet for anyone else's skeletons in their closet. You look at other people, it goes, oh, mine aren't actually that bad.
And the amazing thing about that is that he lists everybody else's skeletons, yeah, and he shares exactly why the other people in this group are where they are now.
Yeah. And then he takes them skateboarding. Then they go skating. It was beautiful.
And then they skate.
I loved it.
And
I actually thought the movie was going to end there. I thought that was the end.
Really?
Yeah. I did
think it was going to be the end, but then I looked at my watch and I was like, it's like 1 hour.
Yeah. No.
This is a TV show.
Pretty much. So, I mean, that's it for me. That's it for you. So, fantastic film. We both really loved this film. What did you guys think? Is it a see it, wait for it, pass it? Do you agree with the things we were talking about? Jump in the comments below.
Like and subscribe if you like this video.
And so, as always, this was not a review, but a mid-90s discussion. Hope you joined the talk with us. Hope you're jumping in the comments, liking and subscribing for everything. Stay tuned. We have, what is it?
The Haunting on Hill House.
Yes, we got that. We're going to review that.
I feel
right
like
now.
We're giving away our discussion piece.
I always want to call. I want to call that the
House on Haunted Hill.
Something like that.
There's a movie called The House on Haunted Hill.
I know. There's also.
I think that's probably why they switched it to The Haunting on Hill House.
It's like a book from a long time ago. It's actually
an adaptation. I don't know. Comment below. Tell us what you remember. Look it up for us. Go to Wikipedia for us because we're lazy.
That's it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time, guys.